Good morning and welcome back. It is now, what day is it today?
Today?
Yeah, today. Not tomorrow.
Wednesday 3 November.
November the 3rd, Wednesday it is. It's a while since I've been making videos, guys. I only put up a small birthday video with Liam. That's because I've been really, really busy last week. Things happening. So, but now I'm back to making videos again, and I'm supposed to make a video today and show how lazy Jessa is sleeping, but then she heard me go showering and I mentioned to her that I'm gonna film, so she pretends to be awake now, but really she would still be sleeping if it wasn't for the camera. And Liam would do too, huh? Hi handsome, good morning.
Hi.
Hi! So...
Clap your hands! Very good! Very good! You're saying hi to camera!
The good news is that our hospital horrors are coming to an end. How did that saga go? How was it last week? The last thing we did last week, we went there with all our results to meet the doctor, yeah?
Yes.
That's what I don't have on video yet, because I think I have video up until then. But then I needed, what was it then? It was
urine.
Urine, yeah, I need my urine to analyze my urine. So then we went and fixed that and delivered that papers. And they told us to come back Tuesday or Thursday. That's the 2 days we could talk with the doctor, yeah?
Yes.
Yeah. So luckily that was on Wednesday, so we just come back Tuesday morning as they said, not Thursday morning as they said, and then we were told that no can do. The guard said not available, was operation or something. The doctor was busy, at least he was busy.
Yeah.
So we could not do, so that means we were supposed to go home this weekend, guys. So that meant that we had to stay until Tuesday. So yesterday we went there, and lo and behold, what did I need when I came there, Jessa? Another blood sample?
Kidney.
Yeah.
For kidney.
They need sample for kidney. So we did that yesterday, but the doc was understanding, so he did clear me for operation. Yeah? I'm clear for operation now.
Yeah.
Yeah, I just need to bring that paper for kidney when I'm coming for my scheduled operation.
Only need to call to
make appointment.
Yes.
So we can go home now. We're gonna call the doc today to make the appointment today to make sure that we can go home before we actually go home. Because you never know, maybe they need me to show up at the hospital one more time. Who knows? I have no idea. But anyway, so that's that. So we have spent, I have no idea. I don't count it anymore because it's gone so long time. But I think we're up to 9 or 10 weeks now. So we've been in the city for like 2.5 months. We left the city for staying there for 1 or 2 weeks. That was the original plan. Then all of this happening, so what we can do. We will go home tomorrow or Sunday. We will make the decision later today. We are extremely tired now. I'm so exhausted. It's so hard living like this. And in addition, some other things popped up that I had to deal with, so it's been a hard week. But I'm back. I need a few days of rest. I can either take that in the mountain or take it right here. We just figure it out as we go. So if the doctor says now that we just need to make an appointment, everything is good, we go home now. One of the closest days we go home. Maybe take a couple of days of relax before we go home, but the point is we're going home. And we're staying home until my operation. When I have my operation, we leave Liam with Diane, right? Diane actually working for us. But she, of course, hasn't been working for a while now, so she's just living in our house, taking care of it, right, Jesse?
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, because Diane needs some money for living, and we cannot afford it, but yeah, we can't watch the girls starve either, and the boy. So we just let her help us out for a small amount of money and a place to stay. Anyway, what was I supposed to say? Going home, yaddy yaddy, blah blah blah.
Liam leaving the mountain.
Oh yeah, Liam will stay in the mountain with Diane and Cyrus while me and Jessa go back for my operation. The online it says like 2 to 3 days in the hospital and you go out again. So if I'm good enough, I'm just gonna go straight home. I'm not gonna do the wedding. We need to save money now. We're out of money now. We're bankrupt. So the house, Jessa's mom's house, we were supposed to help them build a house. We're supposed to finish our house. All of this is maybe 3 to 4 months in the future now for our house. And Jessa's parents' house, that's way in the future now. We can't. It's impossible. We have other things to pay back, right?
Yeah.
So this has costed us money and the operation. We do not know how much it will cost, but we expect it to be very expensive. So that's that. We ended up with a lot of debts over this because of my operation. So when we come back home, it's basically back to what we did when we built the house. Just work hard and pay back the money, and sometime March or April next year we expect to be, we were supposed to be debt free about next month from everything back in Norway and all my debts. That's why we've been living so very cheaply. And now it will be of course extended until March or April next year, but that's how it goes. So when we're debt free, we're gonna finish our house, or in between if we can do both. We just have to see what income will be. I will of course start working much harder again, just for a while, and after done I come back to do more filming. It's just right now we need the money over hobby. And guys, I'm not making much money filming. It is a hobby of mine. And I enjoy it way more than doing my actual work, so I'm trapping down on work and more on my website and the filming that will make more money in the future, hopefully. And but right now I just have to go back to do my boring work. I am not happy working with that, but we need the money, so that's what happens, guys, when you need operation in the Philippines. It's not only the operation cost, we have to stay in a condo for 2.5 months and live in the city for 2.5 months, which has costed us, I don't know, it hasn't been extremely expensive because we're living pretty cheap here, but you know, it's 20, 40, 50,000 plus expenses. So say we spent like 100,000 for the time we lived here now with food and stay, 100,000 pesos. So that means back in the mountain in the same time frame we would have spent like 60,000 pesos. So it's only 40,000 pesos extra, guys. It's not that bad. It's really not that bad. But I miss my mountain. We moved to the mountain for a reason. We are not city people. And as we have found out here, Jessa, we're not really condo people either, are we? It's nice, right? In a condo for a period of time.
Yeah.
But it's not for living.
No.
That's what we found out. We really
it's
not.
It's so many expenses.
Yeah, it's not just expenses. It's just we're kind of private people. It sounds strange because we're making YouTube videos and all of that. But we value alone time and we value relax and peace and all of that. And we value nature and all of those things. And exploring places far off the beaten path and stuff like that. So for us, going to the city is great for 2 to 4 weeks. After that, we just wanna go to a smaller place again. It's cool to be in a big city, but we're not big city people. We just like it for a shorter periods of time. So me and Jess have always been thinking that we're gonna buy a condo in the city. We are not so sure anymore. We actually started thinking about, because back in Norway, we don't need to, since we're living mostly in Philippines and we'll just visit Norway like 2-3 months every year, we do not need a house in Norway. So when we're debt free, we're not gonna start renting anything there or buy land or anything there. There's no need, because my mom selling her house, my dad died recently, and she buy an apartment, and she buys an apartment with an extra bedroom just for me and Jess and Liam. So when we're in Norway, we can stay there. And part of the time we are in Norway, we're gonna show you the country, so we'll be traveling around anyway. So it's no need. So, and since my mom does that, we're gonna help her pay a little bit and every month for the apartments. Just, she's a minimum wage pensioner, you know, and we're just gonna pay a little monthly, like 7 to 10,000 pesos range. That will be like 1,500 to 2,000 Norwegian. When we're all year around, just an automatic pull from our account, just to give her a little bit extra money, because, you know, minimum pensioner, it's not much money, and 1,500 or 2,000 Norwegian will help her to have a little bit nicer life. So that's what we're gonna do. And obviously, if in the future me and Jess get great income again, like before COVID times, we're gonna help out much more. Family is life, guys, and we're gonna help out as much as we can. Right now it's my mom who helped us out because of all this, and borrowing money in Philippines is very expensive. Borrowing money in Norway is not that expensive, but it's still interest. So my mom, just since she has money in her account right now, and she's not buying an apartment until maybe the spring, so she helped us out so we can get through this this period. And that's the money we have to pay back now, that I expect to be finished in March or April. Then we will be debt free again. So that's, everything is still the same, everything is just postponed. And our sailing trip is probably not gonna happen next year, guys. It's just too little time to raise enough money since we're doing all of this. So that means that we're still going to Norway next summer just to visit my family, maybe stay 40 days or something like that. And the next year after that is when we will do a sailing trip. We need some bankroll for that, you know. It's just how it has to be. Everything is still the same, just little bits postponed. So life is good. I don't have cancer. I don't care about the money issues. I'm good. I'm good with working hard to pay back. And Liam, he's a very happy camper, right? Yeah.
Happy camper that bored all the time.
So that's it, guys. We're probably finished by now with all of this hardship of ours. It's just my operation left. I'm very worried about it, because it is scary operating in a foreign country like that. But I put my trust in the doc and hope everything will be fine. So that's that. And on that note, Liam. Hey, I'm filming you, boy. What are you doing? You're riding your horse? It's fun. So on that note, thanks for watching and see ya!
You're growing on my